only time I got to praying for a red light is when I saw your destination as a deadline. It's just normal conversation, babe, it's all fine. Making quiet calculations where the fault lies. It's just good to land, or at least it was. It takes a strong hand and a sound.
Goodbye, everybody.
Love you.
See you.
Bye.
Yay.
That's awesome.
It's been the craziest week, feeling like I can see a chapter of my life closing and another chapter starting. Like, I left work Thursday and I won't be in that town or in that county anytime for any reason in the foreseeable future. Like, I used to have multiple reasons to go up there, now I have zero. It was really weird and emo, and like, it's a job where it's kind of like, I don't think I'll ever see most of you again. Like, it's so weird and sad and bittersweet. But that same day we moved out of our apartment, chaotic. Thank God for Monica, shout out, and my movers. And then I just kind of came home to the suburbs for the night. And so seeing that all happen at once and then packing up to leave for Charleston Sunday and touring apartments all at the same time, like, I feel like I'm in a TV show. Everything's happening at once. It's so crazy.
I think we've always been talking about living somewhere else. I was thinking about it last year. Liv was thinking about it last year too, but it's kind of scary because we love Chicago so much, and everybody we've ever known lives in Chicago. And so we were like, oh, let's go to Charleston for Labor Day. Oh my gosh, Charleston's the best. We love Charleston so much. Christine's moving to Charleston. We're like, wow, we're so jealous. We want to move to Charleston. And then we were like, why don't we? We said, now's the time. Our roommates were like, we are not resigning no matter what. So here we are. What can we do until then? Live in Charleston. Perfect.
Enjoy the Charleston.
Good land, or at least it was. It takes a strong hand and a sound like.
Ah!
It makes me smile to know when things get hard. Ooh, you'll be far from here. That while I clean shit up in the yard, ooh, you'll be far. Far, far from here.
Hey guys, we're here at Buckley's in Tennessee.
Oh my gosh,
1,000
skirts.
Let's see how much of a tab we run out.
Good afternoon, y'all. Welcome to the Buckley's Hall. Jordan, what'd we get?
Local Tennessee.
So, this hall is sponsored by Francis and Teresa, who both sell us money. And so, in return, here are a couple of things we're getting for the fam.
Mary's baby girl due in August. A cute little Bucky's dress.
Gorgeous. Picture her next summer stunting that.
She's gonna be in Texas in this little dress.
Yeah.
Liv and I got matching sweatshirts.
Behold.
What? We wanted Megan Maroney sweatsuits, but this is what they had to offer.
And it's gonna be great.
We weren't leaving without something. No. For Francis's little boy, Cassie.
One year.
Just picture him in his little swim trunks.
Time to swim.
Look at the print. They're like to die for.
We've got dinner on the way with Jordan's brisket.
My brisket Sammy.
Brisket is up. That's what they said in there.
It smelled so good.
Pulled pork. They got us with the smell. So cheers. Bucky's dinner.
Asheville soon.
First bite. I think the biggest bite ever.
Yeah, that's cute.
It's so good.
It's so good.
Look at this perfect little bun.
What a perfect bun.
She's everything to me.
Good old Bucky stop.
Yeah. Mary Kill. Casey's Loves and Circle K.
Okay, I'm going to marry Bucky's.
We've taken a lot of road trips together over the years. How is this one comparing? How are we doing?
Okay, this one's at the top of the list. One, because we're excited. Two, new views. We're taking a road trip usually to the Midwest. So we're going out of the Midwest pretty.
Wow. Oh, baby.
You're the luckiest girls. Alive!
North Carolina!
Okay.
Just straight up in it.
Smile! Talk to me about moving out of our apartment.
Oh my
gosh, right now?
Yeah. It was really weird. His master finale moved out first, so it was like half empty. It was like a really long move out process because they went and then we went. So sad being like empty girlies for a few weeks. But, you know, feeling good about the things ahead. So, like, it was nice to, like, be closing the sad chapter of leaving that apartment with exciting Charleston. If we were just moving to a different spot in Chicago, it would have been, like, man, double sad. But now it's like, oh, yeah, sad we're leaving, but there's so much to look forward to that, like, it's hard to be sad.
Yeah.
Okay, so the 10-hour drive really was kind of feeling like 4 max, I would say. And my pro tip for that would be save your favorite podcast episode for the drive. So shout out Brooke and Connor. We were literally laughing out loud. We did an audiobook, Funny Story by Emily Henry, which we have a little bit more. We'll finish up tomorrow. Stay tuned for the rating. And then two of our wonderful friends called Christine, who were so excited to join us on this Thursday in Charleston. She filled us in a little bit more on the rest of their day yesterday when we went back to the suburbs. And then also Carson called, and he's been living in New York for a month. We miss him so much. And he's also filling us in on his life and planning to come down to visit. So we just can't wait.
So pack up your car, put a hand in your heart, say whatever you feel, be wherever you are. We ain't angry at you, love. You're the greatest thing we've lost. The birds still sing, your folks still fight, the porch still creak, the leaves still die. We ain't angry at you, love. We'll be waiting for you, love.
Okay, so our reason we wanted to go to Charleston is because we visited over Labor Day. That this is heaven on earth. It would be a dream to live here. And while we were here, we were pretty inspired that a short-term rental could be the move because we were here for a few nights and already made a bunch of wonderful friends. Everyone we met,
our closest friends,
was so friendly.
We'll take a bullet for them in the foot.
In the foot. What questions do you have for me about acting like I've been best friends with people I met at the bar?
I have never been happier than I am right now.
We literally just said.
Grocery store that also has like food you can take to go, and I got a pub sub and we've got sushi, and I feel like those are the two things I've seen people get from there, so I feel like we're real locals now.
Today we got mostly unpacked and went to the grocery store, and now we're ending the day
stocked
at the beach
up.
Yeah, and we'll have to do a house tour in the future, maybe a future bed.
Yeah,
everything is going our way,
literally
nothing.
I really feel like meant to be here because nothing has gone wrong.
Yeah, we just can't wait for Christine to join us.
Yay!
Signing off. We're not homeless anymore. Guys, we forgot to tell you the craziest thing that happened today. We got our apartment! We got an email that we won the war. For the apartment. And it's only day one of summer, and we have a place to live. We're the luckiest girls in the world.
That fits all of our needs.
Yo! Bye. For real.